Hello and welcome back to my channel.
As you know, I do love to read your comments and suggestions, and here is one that caught my eye. Under my video on audio interface versus mixer, someone posted, "Can you do a very basic video on what the difference of line in versus mic is, please? Also, low cut, limiter, and compressor." Well, that's really two suggestions. So I'm going to have a look at line versus mic versus instrument level in this video, but I will also come back to the other question on filters and basic DSP at a later date, as I'm sure many of you will be interested in that too. A quick heads up, this is going to be a basic video as requested, and I'm not going to quote lots of numbers and details. So if you're looking at an audio interface or mixing console and wondering about the difference between those different signal levels and what cables and settings you need, then this video is for you. If you want lots of technical detail on impedance, dynamic range and so on, then it probably isn't. I post regular videos on home recording, especially aimed at beginners, so if that sounds like something you're interested in, then do subscribe to the channel. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, it really helps me out. And if you've got any comments or questions, post them below, because I do love to read them and it does help me decide what sort of content to produce next to help you out. Okay, let's crack on. To illustrate the point, I'll be taking a quick look at these two audio interfaces, my older Focusrite 2i4 and my newer 4i4. Although the physical inputs are very similar, there are differences between how you select whether you're connecting an instrument or a line level signal, so we will examine that here. Hopefully it will help whatever kind of mixer or interface you have. The purpose of an audio interface like these is to allow you to record your analog sound sources, so if you want to record your microphones or plug your guitar in directly, or record from a line level sound source such as a keyboard, you can do any of that. The interfaces have built-in preamps and you can adjust the preamp gain for signals by selecting the correct inputs and adjusting gain accordingly. You should be able to get a nice strong signal from your sound sources, being mindful of going too far with the gain and introducing clipping or digital distortion, which sounds very bad. These inputs are all combo type input sockets, so you can connect microphones, instruments such as guitar or line level signals all in the same socket. These combo sockets accept both XLR and quarter inch 6.35mm jacks. This is where you need to understand the different signal levels and appropriate cables. Microphones have the lowest signal level, and the purpose of the preamp is to add gain to boost the mic signal up to line level. Microphones will normally be connected using XLR plugs. The preamp gain is appropriate for microphones when an XLR plug is inserted. You should not connect anything other than a microphone, even if that unit or module has XLR outputs, as the signal level will overload the preamp, resulting in distortion. Plus, if you happen to have phantom power enabled, the equipment might be damaged. Instruments and line level signals should all be connected via quarter inch jack plugs of either unbalanced TS or balanced TRS type. The preamp gain is appropriate for higher level signals when a jack plug is inserted. If your keyboard or sound module has balanced XLR outputs, then use an XLR to TRS cable to connect them to an interface like this. Line level is the strongest level of signal, so if you connect any line level equipment, such as a keyboard or sound module, then you need to make sure you switch to line level. On the 2i4, you can just slide the switch to line. On the 4i4, you have to use the Focusrite controller, which is actually a bit of a pain. I do like the ease of having a physical switch, and I miss that on my newer interface. But nevertheless, if I show you in the app here, I navigate to the input settings tab and switch between line and instrument there. You can see the inst illuminated when you select instrument. If it is not lit up, then it is set to line. If your line level signals are balanced, use a TRS cable. If they're unbalanced, use a TS cable. And if you want more detail about all these different cables and connectors and the difference between balanced and unbalanced signals, then I've got a much more detailed video and blog post on this that you can refer to rather than going into too much detail here. Finally, instrument level is somewhere between mic and line. Because the jacks look identical, you need to make sure you select the correct input so that the gain will be applied accordingly. So here's a quick summary. Microphone signals are the weakest signals and require the most gain. Only ever connect microphones to an interface like this using XLR cables, never connect line level signals to combo inputs using XLR, or at least refer to the manual for your particular mixer or interface to check this, as it may be that you also have a mic switch on your device. I don't, so it's very important I follow this instruction. Only turn on phantom power if you're connecting condenser mics via XLR. Line level signals are the strongest signals and should be connected using quarter inch jack plugs, either balanced or unbalanced depending on the outputs of your particular device or keyboard. Make sure the input is switched to line level so the interface can apply the gain accordingly. Instrument level signals lie between mic and line. Connect using a quarter inch TS jack plug and switch the input to instrument so the gain is applied correctly to that level of signal. Finally, you'll see the gain controls have these tricolour LED rings to confirm signal level. Green indicates an input level of at least minus 24 dBFS, or decibels relative to full scale. That means there is a signal present. The ring then turns amber at minus 6 dBFS to indicate that the signal is close to clipping. And finally, to red at 0 dBFS, which means you actually have digital clipping. If you're seeing that red light, turn the gain down accordingly and start again. And the pad reduces the signal level fed to your recording software or DAW by 10 decibels. You'll find this useful if you need to feed the input from a source whose output level is particularly hot, when you might notice clipping or the gain halo turning red even at minimum gain. So that is the difference between mic, line and instrument levels, and a bit of an explanation about the kind of cables you might need. Well, I hope you found that helpful. Remember, any comments or questions, post them below. I love to read them all. If you enjoyed this video, then do subscribe so that you can get more of my home recording tips and tricks. Do visit my website, where I've got lots of in-depth guides on home recording made easy. I look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you for watching.